What's up, fish fam? I'm Dan from Michigan Aquatics, and welcome to Michigan Aquatics.
Now the shift's about to kick off, this party looks whack. Let's take it back to straight hip-hop and start it from scratch. I'm about to bloody this jack up, everybody get back. That's why my pinions are bad, cause my rhyme's on the red tag. Just like I did with a Dixon, I'm about to freak it. Like a magician, critics, I turn up freak it. Got them still on the fence, whether to freak it. But quick to get impaled when I tell them freak it. So sick, I'm looking pale, well that's my freak it. About to go ahead, now this shout out to freak it. Let's bring it back to that vintage Slim.
Fish fam, I'm Dan from Michigan Aquatics. Obviously, we gotta do ourselves a focus check. It's looking good. Of course, you guys need out. Of course, Malinois needs out with the German Shepherd. Get. All right, we're good now. I'm actually gonna film two videos today. They're gonna be posted on separate days, but today we got ourselves for this Sunday. I was gonna do a pet store Sunday, which I might still upload the clip if you guys would like me to upload the clip anyway. Of me going through Pet Supplies Plus and stuff. Tell me down in the comments. But today, I'm going to tell you how to treat a little puffer for ick. And it's actually quite effective. To an extent. This is my 3-gallon nano tank with the world's best guppy in there. We have ourselves a platinum Dumbo ear, red mosaic dragon guppy in there. A male, I'm gonna be getting a female soon here. And I don't know where he went, he's been out all day, but I also got a super red calico and cistrus bristlenose pleco. I don't know where he is right now, but he's somewhere just sucking on the glass or plastic or something, he's sucking on something. There's my little pea puffer though, you can see it right by the water heater. And it's had some little ick spots for quite a time. Now, it's not affected the behavior of the fish. She's just a little skittish. She was new when she got the ick. Which is ultimately why I got rid of my first pleco. Because it caused the ick in the tank. Which I'm glad I did because I got a better one now. And I really like him. If I could see him, I could show you guys. I'll put some pictures up on screen. Gosh dang it, I just made this more work for me, but I'll do it anyway. This guy's still not colored up, still a little stressed out from yesterday, the adding and everything. But let's get straight into this ick treatment. First of all, what you're going to want to do, you can use a shot glass like I am, or you can have just some sort of small cup or glass. No, this is not alcohol. This is water in here. And what I'm going to do with this water is we're going to put bloodworms in it. Okay? You know, just some frozen bloodworms. Just a cube of it. Like this. Ah, there we go. One frozen bloodworm cube. Popper in there. Alright, just like that. So you guys are probably wondering, Daniel, how is this going to cure ick? It's not. This is the ingredient. Yes, garlic, you heard right. So I'm just going to grab a knife here out of my pocket. SOG Trident. Nice. Very nice knife. About a $90 knife. Not cheap. Not cheap at all. High quality, though. And this thing's just sliding across here. And I don't want to cut too much off of the cloves. Gosh darn it. Well, it cut that, but that's not what I wanted to cut. So after I put down the camera, I realized that all I had to do is take a bunch of the skin off of it, and I didn't really even have to cut it. But, in doing so, I found this little tiny baby clove. But now, we We need to skin it, and we need to cut little areas of it here. Let me just take this time. Now it should not slide, and it's probably going to slide anyway. No, we're good. We're good. This part's going to slide now. Come on. Stop moving. There we go. Now I'm just going to skin it up, and I'll tell you guys what to do next. Skin my piece of garlic up here. Now I'm just going to cut it a little bit more, which it should cut pretty easily now. Yeah. There she goes. Alrighty, now with our cut up pieces of garlic, we're going to put them right in here. Dang it, I missed. Right in here with the bloodworms. Now, I really have no explanation on why that works so good, but it does, so don't question science. Now I'm going to stir this up with these tweezers, and we will wait for further everything. Just wanted to say now that I have the chance to, if you guys aren't subscribed yet, make sure you consider hitting that red button down below. Make sure it's gray and not red so you do not miss future uploads of this beautiful cichlid tank right here. There is my Jaguar Cichlid Clarice, one of the stars of the show, and then there's Frank, the other star of the show. And as well as my next video is actually on my birds, which I have very many of them, specifically on the finches. So, video coming out on these guys soon. Aha, there you are. Now I caught you out and about. And it's not gonna focus. Is it even clean? It's not even focusing right for me. Why? Focus now? Screw off. Still not focusing. It should be a little bit better though. You can see him right there. It's not going to focus on him though. It'll focus on everything else though, won't it? No. Why though? Now focus. I guess you guys are just going to have to deal with it being retarded. Because I want to throw this thing at the ground right now because I hate it. Look at this. Won't even focus on that. And it's completely clean. About time. Dang. Alright, now that it's focusing, I don't know what was wrong with this thing. It was being stupid. But this thing's been sitting for quite a bit. It's all melted down. Been stirring it here. So, the Pleco, where did he go, actually? I just seen you, and I wanted to get some film of you. But you just, like, flew away. Oh, there you are. Hit there. Look how cool he is. Yeah, so now what we're going to do next, reach in here, try to grab one of these smaller ones, like this guy right here, find where the puffer's at, which is this back corner, just going to lazily drop it in. And watch. If he sees it. Hasn't seen it. Oh. There he goes. He got it. Oh, the shrimp's going after him for it. Did the shrimp steal it? No way. The shrimp just stole his bloodworm. What a piece of crap. How? There's another small one. I don't think I'll be able to eat this one. You might.
Oh.
You guys missed it, but he has it. The guppy went for it and then got scared away by the puffer. But the garlic works really good. So just try and soak your bloodworms in garlic before giving them to your puffer. And your pea puffer should do pretty good with that. I'll even give some of them to the guppy because he looks like a hungry champ and he can eat the big ones. The puffer can't. He might be able to eat the big ones. I don't know. We'll give him a little bit smaller of one. Yeah, he'll be able to eat this one for sure. Go in. No, it's still on here. There it goes. There you go, buddy. Oh my gosh, the puffer was going after it, and then... Oh, he spit it. He spit it. Oh. Pea puffer versus the world's best guppy. Rare versus popular. Do you guys want me to breed this guy? I don't know if I'll be able to find a female of him. But I can hybrid it with something that's pretty close to the color or something different from the color and just sell it for the regular price that one usually is. I'll keep giving the puffer some. Ooh, here's a good little piece right here. Come on. Oh, no, wait, that's a big piece. It looks small. Puffer seems pretty hungry today, though, so. Never usually this hungry. Maybe you'll get away with a bigger one. I don't know, though. Not too high of hopes on that. Well, the guppy sees it. Oh, the puffer! Oh! Yeah, he can't eat it. It's too big for him. Don't worry, I have shrimp in here. They'll eat him. I don't think the Pleco will, but he might. You never know. I don't even know where he went. Oh, here he is. Right there. The Pleco might eat it. They put an algae wafer in there, but as you can see, he hasn't eaten that. He's having fun eating everything else, but got like one more ick spot on his back. Everything seems to be working with it. Give him a small piece here, or try to make it a small piece, really. Looks like I did it. Let's see if he'll eat that before the guppy gets it. Nope. World's most beautiful guppy wins again. And then, and the puffer's just late. Oh, he spit it. He really wants to eat it, though. The puffer. Nah, you're not gonna be able to eat that, no way. I swore that I chopped that in half, but I guess I didn't. Oh, dang! He's eating the heck out of it. Look at that. Did he swallow it? He's trying to. Looks like he's gonna eat it. Very surprising. Huh. We'll give the guppy some regular old guppy food too. Good luck seeing it through the duckweed, but if you do, it's there. I promise you. Oh, I think he sees it. Yep, he sees it. I like having the duckweed in there because once they know that food can be up there, they're always looking for it. He's lonely, though. He definitely needs a girlfriend. We'll get him one. Thank you all so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed, make sure to hit the like button and the subscribe button if you have not already. Hope that this video has helped you out, and I'll see you all in the next one. Fish on.